Fellow members, we formed a quorum at the appointed time, and this is the election of the chairman for the panel on development for the 2017-18. Now, in accordance with ROP 776, if a member is the chairman of the deputy chairman of a government advisory body in respect of matters which a panel considers to be directly related to the terms of reference of the panel, shall be the chairman or deputy chairman of the panel. And also 77(7) says that a member shall not be chairman or deputy chairman of more than one panel at the same time. And in accordance with Annex 4 and Rule 22 of the House Rules, please, can we have nominations for the chairman? A valid nomination shall be made orally by members, seconded by at least one other member, and accepted by the member being nominated. So, nominations, Mr. Wong Ting Kwong. Chairman, Mr. Tommy Jiang. Any seconder? Mr. Lam, Jeffrey Lam. I'm happy to accept the nomination. Any other nomination? Let me count. Five. Five, four, three, two, one. Chairman, you have been elected, Mr. Tommy Zhang. Thank you very much. Let's move on to item two, and that is we should be electing a deputy chairman. Any nomination for deputy chairman? Ms. Eunice Yong, Mr. Kenneth Lau. Any seconder? Dr. Lo Wai Kwok. Mr. Lau, do you accept the nomination? Yes, I do. Any other nomination? So I'll count up to three. One, two, three. No other nomination. No other nomination. So Mr. Kenneth Lau is elected the deputy chairman. On the schedule of meetings, let's take a look. We will be using the date as used in the last session, and that is a 2:30 on a Tuesday, on the fourth Tuesday of the month. And for three of the meetings, they fall on a public holiday, so maybe we can fix these other dates as well. On the 26th of December, that's a public holiday, and the clerk told us that the meeting can be held on the 20th of December, Wednesday, 2:30 p.m. because the full council is not in session at that time. Agreeable? Yes. And on the 22nd of May, again, it's a public holiday. I wonder whether it's the Dragon Boat Festival. And we can consider the meeting to be held on the following Tuesday, and that is the 29th of May, Tuesday, 2:30 p.m. Agree? Yes. And on the 24th of July, this will be better because the meeting is going to be advanced. We can advance it to the previous Wednesday, and that is the 18th of July at 2:30 p.m. Are we all agree on that? Yes. Thank you very much. So what else do we have to do? Okay. The clerk told me that actually for this panel, we usually have very long meetings. And in the last session, well, the longest meeting time was 3 hours. But actually, we can hold meetings up to for 4 hours. So we will talk with the administration as to how long the meeting will last. Dr. Eleanor Wong, Chairman, can we ask you to talk as soon as possible to the administration on two things? First, the government has released a plan on ensuring safety of drinking water, and they have never come back to this panel to give an account. So can they be asked to come back as soon as possible? And then the second case is about the agreement on the Dongjiang River that should be signed towards the end of the year. How is the progress, and what is the cost and the content of the agreement? Can we discuss this? Now for the drinking water, they have set it for Q4, and for the meeting on the October, that is not an agenda item. But then upon a request, I will see if we can discuss that in November. I am concerned about short-term tenancy. I hope that this can be advanced in terms of the schedule. Now, a lot of the land plots have been rented out to the luxury flat owners on STT, and a lot of the STT sites have been left idle for a long time. So if the administration can talk to us on that. I don't think this is a matter of urgency, because that has lasted for several decades. But I agree that drinking water should be discussed as soon as possible. Well, in any case, I will convey your views to the administration. The chairman and the deputy chairman will hold a meeting with the government, and we will reflect your views to the administration. Ms. Alice Mack, on items of outstanding items of discussion is fresh water supply in remote villages, and that has been on the list for a long time, lasting from the last session up to this session. Can that be discussed as soon as possible? Well, I think maybe we can talk about this when we discuss the drinking water as well. Actually, all these can be discussed at one go. And then, the discussion will be very lengthy, because we're talking about fresh water supply in remote villages. Another thing, I would also be proposing a private bill, members' bill, to amend the waterworks ordinance. I have written into the clerk yesterday, and I hope to discuss that in the panel. And I want to prevent land owners from overcharging tenants on the water fees, water charges. Mr. Michael Tian, a lot of people would like to ask for a multi-purpose raising ground to be built in Hong Kong. A lot of people support my proposal, so I hope that they can expedite the study on this. Now, for the PA, the CE talked about the new development area. There will be a lot more flats under the GSH rather than the PRH, so I hope to discuss that. And also, the CE talked about the wholesale conversion of industrial buildings for residential purpose. I think this is a pressing task, and we must discuss this. And also, brownfield operators, they will be relocated to land without any potential for development. So if there is progress on that side, then more brownfield sites can be released for our use. I hope that all these can be discussed within this session. Mr. Roy Kwong, well, we started discussing this last year. We talked about industrial buildings, but I'm concerned about the industrial buildings, because that is a subject that straddles across the development panel and also the HA panel. I'm not sure I've heard you clearly. Oh, the arts and cultural workers working in industrial buildings. In the last legislative session, we started discussing that already. Under the House Committee, we had already established a subcommittee. Would that be a more appropriate platform to discuss this, rather than having it discussed here at the panel? The chairman, you mentioned that this matter should be discussed by HAP and development panel, and I know that the subcommittee is still on the waiting list yet to be established. So the issue cannot be resolved immediately, I believe. Well, I would like to set priorities. I want to work on the more pressing issues first. And I think your issue is an urgent one, but then still we have agreed to establish a subcommittee under the House Committee, and let's not deal with it under some other platform, say like the ours and HAP. We'll see when that subcommittee will start working, and if they have still to wait for a long time, then we can further discuss what you proposed. Thank you, Chairman. Mr. Chen Hanpan. Yes? Well, please switch on the mic for Mr. Chan. Thank you, Chairman. I would like to discuss the Hong Kong planning standards and guidelines because, in fact, for many facilities, including car parks and their supply, the source of the problem has to do with the Hong Kong PSG. So I hope that we can have in-depth discussion at this panel. That's in item 28 in the list of outstanding issues. Well, can we advance the discussion of this item because we've been waiting for a long time for this? I understand. Let me talk to the Secretary of Development and see when that can be done. In fact, in the full sitting, I have moved a motion, and that was supported by members. So we wanted to follow up on that at the panel. Now, in your meeting with the Secretary, please strongly urge them to work on this. Yes, for all the issues raised by members today, I would definitely touch on those in our meeting with the administration to be held shortly. And for some other issues which are of interest to us, then maybe we can hold a special meeting. We don't want to affect items where funding is needed and where the item will be submitted to the PwSC and FC. We want to hold those up. So in our meeting with the Secretary, I will talk about all these. Dr. Kwakaki, Chairman, with regard to the village houses, the control, and that is item 24, unauthorized building works in NTEHR. I don't know when the government will work on it. I've received a complaint that on a NETEH, which was built some 10 years ago, I don't know when they will crack down on those. If it is not going to be discussed next month, at least they should tell us when they're going to discuss it. Okay, I will talk to the administration about it and see how much we can achieve within this legislative session. We will have many meetings within session. I hope that you can try to strive for this to be discussed. Well, please appreciate that the administration does have their own priorities for items which have to be discussed at the panel and then later taken to the FC for funding application, then they do have different priorities. Anyway, I'll talk to them about all the issues that you raised. We'll come up with a timetable. There are many members on this panel, and the clerk has arranged for meetings of 4 hours, but I don't like 4 hours. If we want to have in-depth discussions on certain items, I don't mind. But don't try to hold up certain items that you don't like and then have discussions on lengthy discussions on items that come before that. I'll try to be cooperative. This is a big, huge sort of size of panel, and we've raised some 10 items or so. And last year, we didn't manage to discuss a lot of the items, and I wasn't happy. And this for this term, we have a new Secretary, and we'll see how it goes. I don't agree with the fact that some of the items, as you pointed out, are very urgent items. I will discuss with the new Secretary, and for the items raised, I hope that they can give us a timetable. And if possible, we may convene one or two special meetings to talk about items which warrant lengthy discussions. The administration should get prepared before they come to meetings, right? They should get well prepared for any items to be discussed here. Dr. Helena Wong, second round. When we were on the subject of Dongjiang River, it was item 17. So apart from discussing quality of Dongjiang water, we should talk about the agreement and the package I know that this is an urgent item. Well, let's not mix all these items related to water and lump them together because we're talking about different things here. Quality of Dongjiang water, safety of drinking water, etc. Well, we have limited time and there are a lot of members on the panel. We'll try to combine items, but if that's not possible, then we'll discuss them separately. And next, Hong Kong planning standards and guidelines, I agree that that should be done ASAP. I raised this on the 15th of October 2015, 2 years now. And also we talk about open space, RCHEs. We also talked about the car parks, whether there have been planning standards and guidelines, are they outdated or not. And I hope that for the meeting on October, I hope that the URA, Urban Renewal Authority, can update us on the progress of the renewal projects. And they have unilaterally cancelled the demand-led projects. I hope we don't agree with that. Please ask them to explain to us.
Okay.
Mr. Chang and Ben, thank you, Chairman. As for the issue related to trees, some of the invasive species, foreign species, including plants, have already arrived on the country parks. I hope that the government can discuss with us on the policies on trees. As when following up on them, the legislations governing them, as well as the department responsibilities, which I hope you discuss with them as well. Okay. Okay, my colleagues, on the October 24th, and after the policy briefing on this panel, this is the panel on welfare service meeting, and therefore the panel is not able to attend the meeting on that day to discuss the aforementioned issues. We can consider moving to have a special 2 hour extension on October 31st. I'm not very reluctant in extending the meeting from 4:45 to 6:45. The government in October, we have two discussion on the work on the Urban Renewal Authority and a progress report on the heritage conservation initiatives. Any other topics that colleagues would like to discuss? I hope you understand that the next meeting will be only 2 hours long. If not, these two topics will be discussed. So maybe I'll reserve some time on October 31st from 4:45. Since you bring up some issues, maybe for this 1 or 2 hours, we can deal with those issues, hopefully. AOB, and on the joint working group on the West Kowloon Cultural District, this panel and this Home Affairs District panel on the 2016-17 year had agreed to set up a working group on the issues to monitor implementation on the West Kowloon Cultural District, and on extending of tenure 1 year to December 23rd, 2018, to clean up the following work. I'll need to consult the members' views, and you've agreed the Secretariat will issue an invitation to re-invite members to join this joint working steering committee. And this current members, unless they stated they would like to withdraw with this joint committee, they will continue to stay on as members, and the members will decide on their first sitting of this year to decide whether they need to re-elect the chairman and deputy chairman. And there's no other business, I declare the meeting adjourned.